Hello guys, welcome back to my channel. It's your girl Starflames. In this video, we're gonna talk about Jimmy Kimmel slamming Aaron Rodgers after Aaron Rodgers claimed that, you know, Jimmy Kimmel is on the Jeffrey Epstein list or has connections with Jeffrey Epstein. Guys, I'm telling you, it seems as though the people that Kim likes or is somewhat connected to Kim is always as messy as Kimmy Cakes is. I kid you not. Because I've been lurking around through the streets of the internet, and there was one popular comment that I saw as it relates to Aaron Rodgers, and that is, he is such a hot mess that oftentimes even his own relatives and him do not get along. And that's not just because of family differences. They're saying he's toxic. Well, I guess that's the reason why his relationships only last a maximum of 3 years. But then again, he's an athlete and he's a very committed athlete. And sometimes these men are often married to their profession because they love the trust and the, you know, energy that it gives, that rush of adrenaline that they get from playing their favorite sports while making that huge buck. So sometimes it's just that they love what they do and they cannot commit to anything else. But let's talk about what is going on, because also I have to say, Jimmy Kimmel actually knows how it feels for someone to be going in on you, because no one has been more messy than Jimmy Kimmel himself. He jokes a lot about people, but you're telling me that you can't stand a joke, Jimmy? Why are you so thin-skinned? You like to dish it out, but you can't take it, honey? That's not fair now, is it? Let's talk about it, right? No. This is a hot topic. It's trending like wildfire. They're saying that Jimmy Kimmel has reported to Aaron Rodgers' comment about the late night host's potential connection to the Jeffrey Epstein associate list, right? Now, they're saying that during an appearance on the Pat McAfee show on Tuesday, New York Jets quarterback suggests that Kimmel was among those names on the Epstein list. Let me tell you guys, Aaron is a hot goddamn mess. But guess what? Many people are siding with him. Many people on the internet, they're saying, well, if you know you ain't on the list, why are you being so sensitive? Like, you ain't got nothing to worry about, honey, because the list is about to come out. So you don't have to be taking any proactive measures defending yourself, because the list will speak for itself. But then again, I mean, they're saying that Jimmy is just practicing in his defense because he knows his name is on the list. That's what the streets are saying, right? Now, according to what this report is saying, right, Aaron Rodgers suggested that Kimmel was among those named on the Epstein list, saying there's a lot of people, including Jimmy Kimmel, really hoping that doesn't come out. What if, Aaron, what if you're on the list? Like, you know, what if by some weird coincidence, your name shows up on the list? She said that there was one person on the list who was trending in the media a lot, and that was around the time that Cassie had filed a lawsuit against Diddy. He settled, and you know, the streets was just blazing because Miss Sloan Bella had predicted that the downfall of Diddy would have started on November of 2023, and it started exactly November. right? Early November, if I'm remembering, it's the second or the fourth, right? And ever since that, many people have been reacting and more people have been talking about it. Then more lawsuits started hitting Diddy and companies started dropping him. And Judge Prescott was like, I guess it's time to reveal that Epstein list so that the world knows that a lot of you wealthy men that people look up to are really, really dirty. So, you know, I guess a lot of people in Hollywood, they're shaken, they're uncomfortable because this list is gonna change how, you know, the world runs. Honestly, it is, because many of these men and women who are in power, once the list comes out, companies are going to start boycotting them. People are going to start boycotting them. Who knows what the heck is going on? But we know one thing for a fact, and that is things are never gonna be the same. But let's continue with Aaron Rodgers and Jimmy Kimmel, because guess what? I honestly like this for Jimmy Kimmel. You know why? I believe that sometimes, you know, people deserve to get a taste of their own medicine. And I know that even content creators, we do talk a lot. But I've seen Kimmel, and sometimes he takes hard blows at people without any care. He just does it callously, and he has fun doing it. And I think he needs to taste and smell what that is like. But as I said, let's continue, right? So after Aaron Rodgers made the comment on the Pat McAfee show, right, Jimmy Kimmel took to Twitter or X to dismiss Rodgers' claims about his connection to the Epstein list. And he said, and this is what Kimmel wrote, "Dear AOL, for the record, I've not met, flown with, visited, or had any contact whatsoever with Epstein, nor will you find my name on any list, other than the clearly phony nonsense that soft-brained wackos like yourself can't seem to distinguish from reality. Your reckless words put my family in danger." Come on, Jimmy. You know, it's reckless, yes. Okay, but he then further states, "Keep it up and we will debate the facts further in court." Now, what Kimmel is talking about is a fake list that is going around, and it has quite a few people, names like Naomi Campbell, Donald Trump, like some people that you would say, "Ain't no way." Not that we really know these people, but, you know, from you see that list, you're going to say, "Ain't no way," right? No. Let me tell you all also, this report is saying that back in March of 2023, Kimmel mocked Rodgers for discussing the Epstein list and UFOs during a February appearance on the Pat McAfee show. "Did you hear about Epstein client list about to be released?" Rodgers said. "There's some files that have some names on it that might be getting released pretty soon." Kimmel played a clip of Rodgers on his eponymous late night show, saying it might be time to revisit the concussion protocol. Aaron, he also referred to the quarterback as a tin foil hatter, right? So basically, because Aaron Rodgers had an injury recently, Kimmel is basically using that to say, you know, seems as though something is going on with your brain, because you have bumped your head recently. So it seems as though you have a concussion there, and that's why you're talking nonsense. That's basically what he means by that. But guys, this is really all I have to share in this video with you guys. Let me know what are your thoughts, honey. And while you're at it, give this video a big thumbs up, share if you care, and see you all later. Peace.